Good morning, students. And today we're going to start with an important grammar topic, that is determiners. Okay. And as you all know, I have shared with you the revised syllabus for your class 10. So we have here a lot of multiple choice questions. Your grammar is going to be multiple choice. We have discussed about integrated grammar. So it is not going to be just one individual, the item that is going to be tested. Right? So when we do editing, it can be testing of determiners, the modals, of the verb, right? Of the subject verb, agreement, anything it could be there. So we have to revise all these individual items also. Okay? Right? So today, what am I going to discuss? Although you people are aware of it, you have done it a number of times in your smaller classes also. But it is always, I would say, good to refresh our memory about all these topics, okay, right? And this time in your test also, we will be including a few grammar questions, okay, multiple choices. Once again, for your test, it's a reminder to you all, be sharing it at 2 o'clock. And of course, here, please, whenever you get time for it, but don't send it too late, submit it. Attend the test. It's a very, very important that you should attend the test, okay? Secondly, those who have not sent me their speeches and the recordings and everything, send that also. There's still a couple of students who have not sent. So we needed to upload your assessment. Okay? Right? Hope you all will listen to me and do the needful. Yes. Where are these students still joining the class? We are late. Online classes. How can we be late? Now, when we do determiners, determine, fix, right? So what are determiners? They determine the meaning of the word in a sentence, right? Okay. And of course, where do these words come before? They come before the noun. So they fix the meaning of the noun, right? And when this determiner is fixed, your noun is already there, and accordingly, we will be making the changes of the verb also accordingly, right? Depending which noun it comes before, a singular noun or a plural noun. And accordingly, we will be giving the verb also to it, okay? Now, when we do determiners, here are the things that you need to remember here. Articles are also part of the determiners, yes? So sometimes we discuss articles as a separate part also, but yes, they are included under this only. Now, do you remember what are the articles? What are the articles? A, an, and the. Now, let's just quickly tell me, when do we use a? A is? Yes? Is it for a singular, plural? What? A boy, a desk, a chair, isn't it? Right? Is it definite or is it indefinite? It is what? Definite. Right? Yeah? Indefinite. Sorry. Right? Then, of course, here, a group of boys also we can use. Right? A chair also we can use. Isn't it? Right? Yes. So we can use it for both. Right? Then, article here, which one? An. An is there? A little confusing. When do we use it? For the vowel sound? Yes. An. Give me examples, please. An. Apple. Okay. An apple a day keeps the doctor away. So we've used the articles over here. Isn't it? Right? Yes. And of course, what are the vowel sounds we have? Can we give examples? A, E, I, O, U. Okay, right. So an apple a day. We've done apple with E. Okay, an elephant is a. Okay, right. Then I. He got an ice cream as a treat. Yes. O. Yes, like, of course, orange is a citrus fruit. Right? Okay? Yes? Then you, umbrella. Okay? Now sometimes, yeah, these words, they don't generally have that sound. right? Okay, fine. Like he, yeah, when we say he studies in a reputed university, right? So why? Because of the sound, yes? An honest man, H, silent there, right? Of course, we have a consonant, but the sound that it makes. So when we do an here, what we have to remember, we have to focus on the sound, right? So accordingly, if it is a vowel, it can be a consonant also, which is there giving that consonant sound, like we've given honest, isn't it? Right? So then we use an. And the, of course, is the definite article. And right, yeah, you can use it. So the boy with the brown hair, isn't it? The Taj Mahal, the magistrate, right? So the, even for countries also, the United Kingdom, yes, right? Why? And of course here, so before we have, like you have the mountain ranges, yes, right? Something in particular. The Taj Mahal is a wonderful sight. Yes? Right? So the is there, right? Of course, so when we use it there for one of a kind also. Let me have a look who has here joined our room. Yeah. Now, when we move on to the next one, that is, we talk about demonstrated. Demonstrate. Telling about the position here, right? Or of course here, this, that, these, those. Okay? This bag is mine. Okay? That gate over there. Right? Then of course, yes, these mangoes are very sweet. Yes? Can you bring me those books? Okay? So nearness, farness, yes, about the position. So what are the demonstratives here? We have this, that, these, and those. So we should here remember when to use them, okay? Then we have the possessives. Possessives. My, mine, your, yes? Any, you can say word which shows the possessions, right? This book is mine. I gave him my book. Can I have your book? Right? Where are your books? Isn't it? This house is ours. Okay? So possessive. Possessive means ownership, right? Okay? Yes? Fine. Then next we come to, you know, numbers and quantity. This is, I would say, the widest range of the determiners, right? And there are so many things here which we need to remember. Like, of course, numbers, like you have your first, second, right? Two, three, dozen, all that, okay? Then you have quantity. What are the words which tell us about quantity? Now, when we talk about quantity, I have countable nouns, I have uncountable nouns, right? So yes, so depending on which noun I am using, the determiner is going to be used, right? Yes, can you tell me a few countable nouns? Countable. Countable like your benches, right? Chairs, table, houses, books, they are countable. Right? Then what about uncountable? Yes, your hair, right? We talk about the air, or we talk about emotions also, isn't it? Right? So accordingly, we will be using the determiners depending on that, countable as well as uncountable, right? So when we talk about quantity, let us start here with something that we generally confuse. We have like, let's see, what about any and some? So we're going to use words in sentences and then the meaning would become clear, isn't it? Right? Okay. Any in an interrogative sentence. Can you use it? Yes, can I use any in an interrogative sentence? Can you? Yes, use it in an interrogative sentence. Does any of the students have the English book? Any as a question, okay? Some. Or like any in negative, any genuine, use it of course in the negative meaning, right? I don't have any sugar in the house, right? I don't have any nice dress to wear, right? Okay, which is a universal issue, isn't it? Okay, then some is not generally used in a negative way, right? I have some milk, I have some water, right? Okay, right? So yes, so this is one major important difference that you are going to remember. And yes, so like, of course, here, yeah, right, when you want to use something in the negative sense, I would say let us use any, right? And or some, okay? Some is not used in the negative sense, okay? Next, here we talk about others also. We talk about each, every. Each of the students completed their work, right? Yes? So each would be individually, right? I know this group and within that, so definite. Every citizen is required to fulfill his duty, right? So many. So when I talk about each, it would be, yes, definitely within that group. I know that every would be in a much wider sense, okay? Similarly, we have, you know, like we have both, we have all, I have none, then I have neither, either, right? All these things here, neither is none, either. So either you keep quiet or, yes, or don't come to the class. We should not be saying this, isn't it, right? He didn't have either a book or a pen. Right? Okay? None. Yeah, dono mein se a. Right? Okay, when we talk about that, none is nothing there. Right. Now then we move on to the next one. Of course, here it is, which we confuse the most. Few. A few. The few. Little. A little, the little. Now, when I am able to identify which one is countable and which one is not. Few students attended or participated in the competition. Few is countable? Yes. Now, can I make a sentence with a few? Yes, a few. A few means kuch, some. Yes, I have a few friends. Okay, I have a few friends, right? Not many, but yes, I do have some. Okay, right. The few would be very, very definite. The few friends I have are very trustworthy. Okay? Right? So what is the major difference that we have to remember when I use few? It is for countable. Okay? Few. Once again, for your indefinite things. Right? But of course here, like as we said, few students participated in the competition. Right? A few students were able to finish the race, right? So the few students who finished or participated in the race won a prize. Clear? Is it clear? Similarly, if I have to talk about little, A little, the little. Where am I going to use it for? Little would be for? Very less quantity, right? Right. So can I say I have little friends? No. Right? So it would be for uncountable. Yes. I have little water in my bottle. Yes. Okay. Right. Yeah. And then a little. Little means not much. Right. So when I do hear little, I would also want to discuss much and many. So much and many would be the same. I would say just like the for countable as well as uncountable. I'm coming to that also next. A little. Can you make a sentence with a little? Can you make a sentence with a little? Little, sorry. Yeah, I have little milk in the house, or I have little water in the bottle, right? A little means very less, right? A little water is left in the river, isn't it? Yes. Then if I have to the little, usi little ke baare mein, we're talking about that very less amount that we have. I drank the little water I had in the bottle. I was so thirsty. Okay? So what are we supposed to remember here? That little is going to be for uncountable. Like, so for water, milk, sugar, right? Yes, so like that kind of a thing. Efforts. Efforts. He made little efforts to study, or you can say win the race. Right? He made a little effort to climb the wall. Yes? The little efforts made by him gave good results, right? So of course, once again, it can be for your abstract also. Fine? Abstract nouns, right? So here it is. So what about much and many? I have many friends. Do I say I have much friends? No. Many of my friends are going for the school trip. Yes? Right? So much is once again for uncomfortable. Much ado about nothing. Why is there so much noise in the class? I don't see why is there so many noise in the class. Right? So these things you have to remember. And remember here, these little words, when you put them into sentences, I think so we can get the meaning much, much clearer. Okay? Much clearer or many clearer? Much clear. Okay, fine. Now here, if you look at your books here, there are certain common mistakes which are done. Right? And yes, I have no any friend. Any is already in the negative sense. And any generally, mostly I would say, we are there in the interrogative. Okay, I have no friend. He is a man of a few words. That means kuch. Right? He is a man of few words. I have not some ink. Once again, no ink. Okay? Right. Little money is better than none. See, there's a very thin line between little, a little. So a little money, a little is something, right? Little would be what? Not much. Okay? My all friends were present. Look at the sequence there. All my friends were present, yes. All mangoes are sour. All mangoes are sour, right? All my family members are here. All my family members. We generally say this, right? All of the members, or all the members of my family, are here. His both sisters are graduate. Both sisters are graduate, or both of his sisters are graduate. There were no less than 50 boys. Boys, fewer, isn't it? So remember what we are using it. Okay, the villagers have not done nothing. Not done nothing. So once again, you say, ma'am, I can say the villagers have done nothing. I can also say the villagers have not done anything. So we can correct it that way. So come on, let's open our book and let us see these questions here. It is page 325. Please open to 325. And both ways, you know, just look at it here. Look at the first set of questions. What is there? The sentences have been, you know, in a put in a jumbled way. You have to rearrange them to make meaningful sentence. And you have to find a determiner, right? Let me see. And for those of you who don't have the book here, let us just go through it. First sentence is, you have how much experience got? Yes, you have how much experience So how much experience have you got? Let us look at the next line. I, a little, brought apple juice market from the. Yes, I brought a little apple juice from the market. Completely being deaf, can't anything he hear? Yes, Bhavin? Yes, being completely deaf, he can't hear anything, right? Both ways you can write it up. Nothing is open, so it's a public holiday. So in between, so what would be the order of the sentence? It's a public holiday, so nothing is open. Right, next one. The few rupees had I spent already. I've already spent the few rupees I had. Okay, fine. Ink in the bottle, much how there is? How is your interrogative? You start with a WH? Yes, so how much? Yeah, how much ink is there in the bottle? Okay, next. Raju writes, can with hand either. Either is, here it is, both. Right? Otherwise, either is one. Either you can write, stay with me, or you can go to your aunt's place. So I'm giving you a choice, either. Yes, here. Raju can write with either hand. Left also, right also. Either, either. Other section in the any friend don't have you? Yes? Don't you have any friend in the other section? Right. Next one, a apple and a the keeps away doctor. Yes, absolutely correct. In this book, are there pages how many? Yes, so it's very, very important when we frame sentences. So many is used for countable or uncountable. And remember here the verb also, right? So a singular noun will take which verb? Singular. And a plural noun will take? Plural. Okay, these are the things that you remember. Now, let's see the answers already given there. Oh my God, I didn't notice. Let us do this then. First one, fill in the blanks with A and other. She bought dash and dash. Ink pot. She bought a book and an ink pot. Kanta is dash taller of them both. Kanta is the taller of them both. Comparative Neha is the tallest. So we can use here because A is not appropriate and is also not there. So we can. He narrated dash interesting story. Very easy here with sound. He narrated an interesting story. All dash books were lying at sixes and sevens. All the books. I am dash student of dash university. Yes, I am a student of the Kurukshetra University. Okay, you are a. The means definite, as if you are the only one. No, there are so many. Dash farmers are plowing their fields. The farmers, right? She had dash umbrella in her hand. She had an umbrella. This is dash useful book. Yes, so you is there, right? This is an useful book. A sound is there. This is a useful book. Yes. Now with demonstratives and possessive. What are the demonstratives one? This, that, these, those. And possessives. Mine, your, yours, his, hers, ours, all that. Dash brother is very intelligent. My brother is very intelligent. You can say his brother is very intelligent. You don't want to praise your brother. Okay. Dash grapes are sweet and juicy. These, because, and of course, remember grapes. So these grapes are sweet and juicy. Dash team could not score any goal. That team could not score. Or our team could not score any goal. You can write that also. He has broken Dash slate. He has broken my slate. He has broken his slate. Yes? Fine. The rays of the sun fall on those flowers. These flowers. Okay, demonstrative. Okay. Would you like to have dash, pen, or dash? Yes, very correct. Absolutely correct. Full marks here for getting the right answer. Would you like to have this pen or that? Right? So singular, this and that. His father is a teacher, and dash father is a doctor. Yes, his father is a teacher. And is it? Yes. His father is a teacher and my father is a doctor. Are there any girls in your class or in this class? Right? Okay. So sometimes there are a wide variety of answers here. Next one, with suitable determiners, it could be anything now. It could be a quantity, it could be a demonstrative, your articles, anything, possesses. How dash money do you want? Much, right, very good. Dash umbrella is dash useful thing. An umbrella is a useful thing. Very good, clap for yourself. He asked me for dash money, but I didn't have dash. Some money, but I didn't have any kuch bhi nahi, any matlab negative mein. Some is for, like, of course, you have a certain amount, okay? N is little amount or no amount at all. Dash book you want is not with me. The book you want is not with me because it has a particular book. Dash more one has, dash more one wants. The more one has, the more one wants. Very nice. She is dash by birth, not dash European. Yes, she is an Asian, not a European. Okay. How dash milk do you buy daily? How much? Have you dash complained against me? Any interrogative, some nahi aayega. It is any. Okay. I have already spent the few rupees I had. Definite, whatever. I can't control myself. I spent all the money that I had. Okay. Next, he lay unconscious for an hour and okay, yes. One goes to Dash University to receive education. to the university. Okay, so nice. So thank you all. So we meet tomorrow, and I want you to bring your books with you, and I'll tell you which pages to complete. Yes? Okay. Yes.